Welcome back, everyone. This is section two. This will help you get MinIO up and running on your system. Hopefully you checked out section one, which was how to install the MinIO server binary on your Linux systems. In this section, we'll show you how to easily, with a single command, get the MinIO server up and running on your system. And basically, we've installed the MinIO binary. Next, we need to create a directory to store the data that we'll be uploading via the web UI. And then we're also just going to run this and access the web UI and show you how to create a bucket and upload a file. As a last section, we're also going to show you the MinIO command line client, or MC client. And we're actually going to connect it to this running server and show you how you can list some of the files that we've just uploaded. So let's jump into the lab here. In this lab, we're going to get the MinIO server actually up and running on the server. We're going to access the web UI. Then we'll create a bucket and upload a file just to test. We'll view that file in the local OS, and then we're going to connect to this server using the MinIO client, or MC client, and query that server to see what's on there and learn some more about the version. So let's jump into it. First thing we want to do is create a directory to actually save the data that we upload into the web UI into. So that's going to be just in our home directory and the MinIO directory there. The next thing we just need to do is run a single command. This command is just MinIO server. We're telling it here that we want to save the data into the home directory of our current user slash MinIO, and that we want the console address to be 9090. We'll go ahead and hit enter. And you can see here that now it's running in the foreground, but it does give us back some information on how to access this system. So if you look down here, you can see that the console address is 5161.99.34 on port 9090, and it gives us the MinIO admin user. So we can go ahead and access this. It also gives us the MC command client that we can use, which we will use later, to actually configure the MC client and communicate with the server as well. So let's go take a look at the web UI. So as you can see, clicking that link brings us to the web UI, and if we log in with the provided username and password, then here we are up and running in the web UI for MinIO. Note that there isn't anything created right now, so we can go ahead and create a bucket. And let's go ahead and upload a test file. All right, so now that the test file upload is complete, you can see that there is a bucket called MinIO test with a 1 gigabyte zip file, a test file that we've uploaded to that. Let's jump back over to the console here. And we actually have to hit Control C to exit out of that. Now, this is because we ran it from the command line. Now, we could do something like append it with an ampersand to run it in the background, but that's really not the right way to make this persist. In the next section, we're actually going to talk about running this as a systemd service with a configuration file. And that's going to be the recommended production method, rather, of running MinIO, a server on your system. But now that we're here, let's actually take a look and see what files were created when we create a new bucket and uploaded that file. So we can clear the screen, and we'll do tree minus H for human readable, and we'll say MinIO. So as you can see here, it actually created a directory called MinIO test, the same as the bucket name, and also created a 1 gigabyte.zip. And you can see that that is actually just a directory. Underneath that, there's actually some more metadata or information about that. And there's the part of this. Now, if we had a highly available distributed system, then it would have sharded that single file across multiple drives to give you some redundancy, or even multiple servers, and it would have used erasure coding to basically protect that and allow for a number of server and drive failures. But in this case, we're using a single directory and a single server, so it put all of that 1 gigabyte file in the same place. It also has this metadata file, which is important for if you're searching or want to add additional context to these files, which is why this becomes so good at scale, because you have so much metadata capabilities in here. But you can see that this structure looks just like it did in the web UI. Now, one thing to note is that because we were running that in the foreground, the server is not actually up and running right now. So if we went back to the console and tried to refresh it, it's going to time out because the server is not actually running. But all we have to do is go back up to that command again and run it again. And if we come back over here, you can see that this server comes right back online and all your data is there. So it basically reattaches to everything that you uploaded before. It's all there. And you can see that 1 gigabyte file is actually here. So the next thing that we want to do is actually run this mc alias command. And so I'm going to use the second tab here because I actually need to keep this up and running right now. But if we come over here, getting ahead of myself. We actually need to install the MinIO client first. So we're going to run this command here, wget, and this is directly from the doc. So go ahead and follow along with that. But this will install the MinIO client. Next thing we need to do is make this client executable. So let's say chmod plus X. So now if we look at this, we can see that the MC client is here and it's executable. Last thing we need to do is to move this into our path. So we're going to move it to user local bin MC. So now if I go which MC, you see that MinIO client is there. Now I can actually run this. So this is basically saying MinIO client alias set. In this case, we can set it to my MinIO or to make it more understandable, we're going to say we're connecting to the local server. So we're just going to call that local. And the address is this HTTP 9000 address because actually connecting to the API. And then the username and password are MinIO admin, MinIO admin. So now you can see local is added successfully. And if we query the server with MinIO admin info on local, you can see that it's been up for 1 minute. We can see the version. We can see that we have one network, one drive, one pool, and then there's 1 gigabyte used because we've actually uploaded a single 1 gigabyte file. Also, we can list the files that are in here. So we can do mcls local and see that there's a MinIO test in there. And I think there's like an ls minus r, which will do recursive. And it'll actually show us the MinIO test bucket has a 1 gigabyte.zip file inside of it. So that's really all there is to get this up and running from the command line. As I said, this is, you know, just a great way to get this server up and running quickly if you want to run it natively in Linux. However, if you want to persist it, make sure you check out the next section, which is going to be configuring systemd, configuring the MinIO configuration file, setting up TLS certs, and actually getting this running as a systemd service so that we can persist through reboots and things like that. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to you guys in the next video.